Barber Shop Podcast, episode number 153. You gotta like that, yeah. Numerology. 1 + 5 = 6.
And what day is it?
The 3 is 9. It is the 21st of October, year 2015. It is Back to the Future Day. How long have we all been waiting for this day since Marty McFly in his puffy jacket came to 2015 and predicted the future for us all back in 1989 when this film was done? A fascinating piece of not only cinematography, but science, pseudoscience.
It's full of pseudoscience.
The kind we embrace here at Barbershop Podcast. And as fate would have it, our very second episode, way back in December of 2012, featured two of the principals we have tonight in Blind Mule, Graham Peacefull, and Joey Balducchi. We spoke about Blind Mule. We were audio only at the time. There was none of this fantastic video, and there was no music live played, and they said, we shall return, like MacArthur in the Philippines. They swore they would return, and they returned on Back to the Future Day. And we're all pumped about it. Ryan Cannon, Gary Greenland, how are you doing tonight? Are you excited about Back to the Future
Super
Night?
Super excited. I'm waiting
Barbershop
for my
podcast.
Hoverboard coming. Hoverboard's on the way.
Amazon. You got that shit by Amazon, right?
Amazon, my hoverboard.
It is so true. And there was a prediction in that movie. If you look very carefully, it says Blind Mule.
Yeah.
You know, if you look in the background, when the little kid's pointing to his junk, you know, it's the Blind Mule you have to look for. It is a smoking great band full of some of the best musicians here in Hamilton. It is infectious kind of groovy music. They came by on this night, and we are going to find out what's been going on with Blind Mule, where they are now, and we're going to do what we do best, and we're going to feature them playing live here tonight. I want to thank everyone who's come tonight. Joey, you are, you know, a great player in the Hamilton music scene with what you do with Spherical Productions. You're a musician and someone who loves music and works with it as a business. Why don't you help be our mouthpiece in the Reader's Digest version? What's going on with Blind Mule, certainly since 3 years ago?
Well, we've done a lot. Blind Mule has been touring a bunch, played a ton of festivals, but we took a little bit of a break. A couple of the guys had some babies, and they wanted to focus on family, and so everyone kind of jumped off a little bit, but we're back. You know, me and Graham started the band in 2007. We started as Peacefull and Balducchi.
Mm-hmm.
Went on the road, opened up for Trooper. It's true.
Yeah.
And
nice.
It was pretty awesome. And anyways, then we ended up getting Jon Edwards. We slept in a parking lot that night, yeah.
Opening for Trooper, sleeping in a parking lot. It doesn't get better.
We were actually playing a show just outside of Thunder Bay. Just outside of Thunder Bay, and this promoter contacted us while we were on the stage, and the bar keep there says, Joey, come here. So he kind of stopped me in the middle of playing. I went over, I picked it up. He's like, Joey, can you cancel your show tomorrow? You want to open up for Trooper? And we're like, look at Graham. You want to do it? He's like, sure. I'm like, okay, yeah, we'll do it. Canceled the show. Played, and we actually even got an encore. We played our first set, we opened it up, and then we got off like, no, keep going, man, you're doing great. I'm like, okay, man. There's like 5,000 people in this town called Marathon, Ontario.
Wow. We have to apologize.
I've been to Marathon.
Not being able to show up to that show because we had canceled for Trooper.
Yeah, we had to, yeah. But it was a momentum. Yeah. It was a momentum occasion. And years ago, when me and Graham were in a band called Golden Lake Diner, we played some shows with Omar Sanchez, which was Jon Edwards' band back in the day. And years later, John used to come to this open mic that we put on at the Che Lounge. And he used to play, and he had this great, great music. And then all of a sudden, you know, he's like, hey, man, what do you think? Maybe I can join your band? And I said, sure, I'll talk to Graham. And then Graham's like, sure. So boom, he's been here ever since. And then we ended up getting Josh Snively, a fantastic drummer.
Oh, is he ever?
Oh, yeah, fantastic. And best hair in the band.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
I don't know. Gabe's
got pretty good hair. Yeah,
John's in there, too.
The whole rhythm really section.
That's actually, it's actually.
I'm the worst hair.
Between me and Graham, yeah, these three guys here, first, second, and third prize, right?
Just been lit over there. Ah, shit, it's me. I'm the worst.
But I think what everyone has a sense of right now is there's a brotherhood and a community and a likeness and a joy that happens with Blind Mule. And I guess it has to be paramount in the way you write and what comes through, right?
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah. Graham, you want to talk on that one?
It's going to be a whole bunch of new stuff coming up.
Yeah.
So it's going to be I think it's going to be a different style of writing altogether.
Yeah. First song
we really?
Yeah. Yeah. It's turning, I think it's going to turn into something
dark and angst-filled.
I don't know if it's going to be dark and angst-filled, but I think it's more going to be co-written now. Like usually somebody would write something, bring it in, and then it was all structured out. Now it's going to be like, an idea and throw it out. Everyone's got their garage band on their phones now, and everyone's going to be just doing shit and throwing it off.
We've talked about that before, the power of being able to co-write, not be butthurt and realize that the people you're working with have your best interests in mind. So if they make a suggestion, you know it's for the better. So you must be looking forward to this kind of writing.
It's going
to
be a lot of fun.
Well, I'm looking forward to it. Can you start off and play a live one for us right now? And just cut the chatter and get to the tunes.
What is this called?
Well, tentatively, this is a new one Graham and I just penned together. This is our first song we've ever written together. Yep. We're tentatively calling it Fame Fortune.
Fame and Fortune. Yes. Well, you're going to hear it live, and we've whipped it together in Boxo Studio, and it's right here, right now, at barbershoppodcast.com.
And settling our scores, fame, fortune.
right, Blind Mule right here, Barbershop Podcast, your place for the very best in live music and musicians each and every week. We bring it out Wednesday nights on Twitch TV. That's twitch.tv/podcastbarber. Podcast Barber also being our handle on Twitter. Give us a look, a like, a share, a follow. We'll take it all. Get on the internet. Help us out. Help us out. Because what we're doing is we're spreading the joy of live music. And we got a good, healthy slice of it right here with some Blind Mule in the house tonight. I want to give a shout out to our good friends at HamiltonArtist.ca because eventually you're going to have to print something on something. We all know about promoting our product, and be it on a hat or be it on a shirt or be it on a 55-inch piece of vinyl that you can wrap around in series. It doesn't matter what it is. They do it at HamiltonArtist.ca. They're 1141 Main East at Balmoral. Check them out. Join their club. They give you discounts. They give you services. They're good people. They're friends of the show, HamiltonArtist.ca. We've got Blind Mule in the house tonight, and I have to ask you guys, been involved in music for a long time, Grand Peacefull, what is the most important component of a song? You know, I know they're like women. There's tall ones, short ones, you know, different color. You know, they're all beautiful in their own way, but there's something magical that makes it crazy. What is it in a song? What do you have to have in a song?
Joy playing it.
Joy playing it. Yeah, it can't be work.
Can't be work. Well, I'm still, like for myself, I'm still learning the process of it, yeah. Like just to strip everything down to less, yeah, and let it breathe more. So it's a fun process. Yeah. I used to complicate the hell out of everything, so now I'm trying to simplify everything, trim the fat.
It's true, as we get older, yeah, we got less room. We don't have more, well, we get more crap and less, the same amount of space that's filling up. So when it comes to writing, it's interesting that, you know, space and a sense of breathing,
yeah,
and communication. Clearly, you know, you got a smoking rhythm section with the band. Having a groove is important too, right?
Well, you should go around and see what everyone says about it.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Okay, what do you think?
Most important part of the song? I'm going to say hooks.
Hooks.
Yeah.
Yep.
You got to reel them in somehow.
Yep.
It's like fishing.
Yep. Joe Varga Sr. said you got to have more hooks than a tackle box. A good song's got to be. And Joey, you work with so many, you know, and different styles, incredibly different styles.
Yeah,
but
absolutely.
Is there a common theme that...
You know what? It's a feel. You know, if I can... like. Today I was listening to the sampler that I gave you, the spherical production sampler, and I just kept listening to it over and over again, and there were so many different styles, and everyone just made me feel good. And I thought that was a really, really great thing. Yeah. You know, like if you can make someone feel really good in music, it means you win.
Well, we're all winning here at Barbershop Podcast. We win every week because someone comes in here on a Wednesday and they give a little bit of themselves, and I mean that in every sense of the word. What they pour out emotionally, the work that's gone into become a professional musician, and then the synergy when it all comes together, like a, you know, beautiful presentation, a beautiful piece of art, a meal, whatever it is. And pleasure to have you guys in the house tonight. We're going to get you strapped up, and I'm going to get you right back to work, you know, playing. Cool. Do you want to tell us about this next song, or is there going to... You can say
should
no.
Just,
that's okay.
No, let's do both. Let's do both.
Yeah, okay.
Graham, Ghost of Caroline.
This Ghost of Caroline. Coca Love Alcorn. If you know Coca Love Alcorn or not?
No, I don't.
She wrote a song called, it was a song about Caroline.
Yeah.
And,
Caroline.
And it was, it's been a lot of time since I thought about it, but it was, her song was a very folky song, and so I did a spin-off of it called The Ghost of Caroline, where this woman has been waiting for her husband to come back from the sea, and that ship went down, so it's like a ghost ship. So she's now still waiting, so it's like the ghost of her seeking out the ghost ship. It's been a while.
It's been a while
since I thought about it. The story behind it.
And you get to hear it come to life right here.
Yeah.
Right now. Barbershoppodcast.com.
Oh, yeah, you can.
Somebody by the tide, the waves crashed all around her. staring at the sea and waits for what I want. The rumors of a life with a sailor and his wife, with the sea his memories of all the ships she's brought down. Men still haunt the waves long after they have been drowned. The crew heard the call for the light to guide them home. So there she cries, killing time by the lonely tide. Wandered, widowed her, now she's the tragic bride. And I'm waiting until the morn to see the night I believe my eyes. Well, I saw the ghost of Caroline.
I saw the ghost of Caroline.
I saw the ghost of Caroline. And she went on. She went under. Is that the screams of men or just the crash of thunder? The crew heard the call or the light to guide them home. Now Caroline, she waits, she sees the dead ship passing, and a ghost walks on the waves and yells out for the captain. Has anyone survived?
No!
The dead ship just sails on by. So there she cries, killing time by the lonely tide. Wandered, widowed her, now she's the tragic bride. And I'm waiting until the morn to see if I still believe my eyes. I saw the ghost of Caroline.
I saw the ghost of Caroline.
I saw the ghost of Caroline, and she went on. Your feet up, feel it's not your home. There's a stain inside the teacup, but not your soul. Is someone gonna cast the first stone? Feel sad without a reason. What I ask, you don't know. And we sense upon each other that we've both grown, but there's a distance in your eye that seems unknown. So mull it over for tonight. By the morning, well, everything should be alright. The grays will turn to skies when we realize the sky returns to gray, but we both did it our own way. Our own way. You look good without your makeup, all stripped to bone. You don't need to dress up, cause you just glow. So mull it over for tonight. By the morning, well, everything should be alright. The grays will turn to skies when we realize when all that at the end, and the sky returns to gray, but we both did it our own way. Feet up, but feel it's not your home.
Beautiful stuff from Blind Mule right here at Barbershop Podcast. Blind Mule is going to be playing tomorrow night, Thursday, the 22nd. Of October this year, 2015, at This Ain't Hollywood. And if you want to check them, you should check them out. Great band live. They get your bum shaking. They get your mouth smiling. Bum. You got to like that. You know who else I like, Ryan Cannon? You do. I like Disc Runner. I got to give a shout out because we got a mini concert that's flowing fast and furious in here tonight. I don't want to forget our sponsors. I love Charlie and the boys at Disc Runner. Eventually, you're going to want to have your music put onto something, and they basically print anything and copy anything. And if it's disc-worthy, they're going to take care of you. DiscRunner.com, look them up. They've got online, you know, packages here where you can kind of design your own deal. You can put in what, you know, you want, how many of what you want, and you'll get a price quote right on there. So, you know, they'll stick to that. You know what you're dealing with, and even a dummy like me can operate it. You know, go check it out, discrunner.com. You want to get CDs, you want to get Blu-rays, DVDs, whatever. They're friends of the show, so I hope you are good to them. Tell them Kev sent you, barbershoppodcast.com. Blind Mule in the house tonight. Everyone is busy. Music is kind of an evolving thing, you know. What part of music, before we go into the next tune, you know, it's changing, and a bit of it's precarious, a bit of it's dangerous, but people speak of a resurgence. How are you feeling in your gut, Joey, about what's going on right now?
With the band?
Well, with music in general.
Oh, you know what? I have a... It's interesting, because I'm in many different... how can I say?
Hats.
You know, I have many hats these days. Like, I went to this conference this weekend called Folk Music Ontario, and I didn't go as a musician, but I went and I showcased a bunch of great acts and this and that. And it's interesting, because like, hey, who is this? Who's this Blind Mule? And who's this Tall People? Da da da. And these are two projects I'm a part of, but I kind of like, I didn't tell them until after the conference because I didn't want to have that hat.
Right.
You know, and I didn't. They said, oh, it sounds really good. You know, right on. Maybe we'll do some business together. So that's really cool. But I think with music, there's just so much great music out there. I'm thinking the stuff that I focus on is not the mainstream right now. Like, mm-hmm. the big mainstream, like, I was checking it out the other day on Spotify, and the top 50 was, like, like the Lady Gagas and the and the Keshas and all this kind of stuff, and which is not bad. Like, you know, they have, everything has a demographic, and the demographic that buy CDs are the young folks. You know, when I was young, you know, that's the stuff that was popular is the stuff that I was buying, because we all had this, we just all had this expendable money, right? And now we're like in our late 30s and stuff. Now we don't have any money left, right? So now that's what makes up the charts. But there's so much great music out there, and I really do hope that a lot of people will go out and support as much live music as possible, because that's how people are making money these days, is the live show.
And don't ever let the fact that you don't know the name of that band slow you down. You know, go in and find out.
Just go check them out. Yeah, check them out. You know, and these days you can just see a name and go, oh, I want to go out tonight. Then all of a sudden you just put it on YouTube and they're like, oh, they sound pretty good.
Yeah, boom. Exactly.
It's that easy these days,
as opposed to online.
Before, you just blindly went out if you didn't know any of the acts.
And now you put in Blind Mule, you're going to find this, which is great, because you've been doing stuff talking about Blind Mule, and now people are going to hear what they sound like as of Back to the Future Day, 2015. Like. Smell what they hear like. I love it. All right. We're going to get it.
Sounds going to be all instinct. Oh, we're doing it.
Pick it up.
All right. So hook us up with some more live music. Mr. Peacefull, Mr. Balducci,
this
and
one's,
company.
Johnny.
Is it Johnny's song?
Yep.
Johnny. Has it got a sad story attached to it, Johnny?
No, everything has a sad story attached.
The only story about the song is I tried to write a song putting myself in the perspective of a drop of water in its life cycle. Cool. So if you think about that whole thing.
That's awesome.
Yeah, that's what it is. I don't know. That's what I was thinking about when I was writing it.
Cool.
But yeah.
Has the group cam good? Is there
I'm just wondering if camera 4 is cool, because I don't want to miss out on this great shot.
Okay, well, go ahead and adjust it for us. We can do it.
You can do it.
A little bit more headroom. Oh, jeez. Never hire
I just don't want to screw that up. There we go. Yeah, I'm not going to move this song.
All right.
Cool. Nice. All right. Sweet. He's got that patented. Sweet. So, yeah, this song's called Picking Up Your Feet, even though water does not have feet. check.
There's been a foot of water here and there before.
That's true. Yeah.
I'm not getting any monitor, but it's fine. I can sing the song without monitor.
Sing with joy.
I will sing with Joey. Ready, guys?
Energy, gossip, blow, moon, gravity.
taking on but finding faults. Journey's long, we've earned a salt. Waited far long to be free. Cast our lot into the sea.
Shimmering Blind Mule, great to have them back. They're here for a good time, not a long time. We're going to play a quick little track, and I'm going to try to talk you into play one more before you head out. I want to hear about the Tall People, a little project that you did kind of in the interim, when people were having babies. You had to play. You were talking at the time. You were saying, I got to play. I got to do something, right?
Well, it was exactly that. Everyone had their own little things going on. Everyone was focusing on family. Everyone was doing and I just, you know, I really wanted to kind of find my voice. So that's exactly what I did. I took some time, and I actually, like, you know, I was recording myself and actually just being like, okay, well, that's different, you know. I'm still trying to, you know, there was many years where I was trying to be someone else where, the best voice that can come out of anyone is their own.
Yeah.
So that's exactly what happened.
And you wrote a beautiful song about a beautiful woman, didn't you?
I wrote a song about my wife.
Yeah.
And I was going to play it at my wedding, but then all of a sudden the energy was going up and the song was mellow, so I decided not to, and I ended up recording it and putting it on the sampler.
Yeah, and I remember when you put it online, I listened to it, and I go, yeah, that's love. It's a great tune, and we're going to play it for you right now. It's called With You, I Feel So Loved, a little something from The Tall People at barbershoppodcast.com.
My 12th grade of high school, I saw the lady that I'm gonna marry, but I did not know that she had my heart. Until years later, when we found each other again, in my this time, nothing like I've ever seen before or now in my lifetime. My eyes were blue to you like you were.
too shy to speak, but I could not walk away.
Packing up, getting ready to go to our friends at Homegrown Hamilton, King William Street in Hamilton. You can check them out tonight if you're watching us live on Twitch TV. Got a couple members going to check out, play some live music. It is hot and heavy every night of the week in Hamilton, Ontario. We provide a little taste of it every week. Next week, you are in for a true treat because we're going back to the future again with Mr. Frank Corrin. But this episode is not finished. This episode is leaving room for a sequel. And I have a feeling that Grand Peaceful, Joey Balducchi, and Blind Mule will be coming back with all of their magic and all of their wires and all of their mystic ways. And we'll see you next week on Barbershop Podcast. For Ryan Cannon, Gary Greenland, Michael J. Fox, Christopher Lloyd, and all of the magical people, welcome back to the future.